two masters replicate to each other. So if the one master goes down, you switch all connections to the other master, and your operation can continue. But at some point, you'll want to expand, or you'll want to make these scale over transparent to your application, which is something that I'm going to do. This is the other setup that a lot of people use. One master, a bunch of slaves. It's very nice because you eliminate the single point of failure on the slave level, but you still have a single point of failure on the master level. If your master goes down, you're in trouble. So what you really want is two masters that fail over to each other, and a bunch of slaves, so that if the slave goes down, you'll always have one or two more slaves to use to process all your queries. And if a master goes down, you can reconnect all your slaves to your master. This has a problem, though, because if master 1 goes down and all these slaves are connected to master 1, you'll have to manually reconnect all slaves to master 2, which is kind of big. So it's nice that we have a piece of software for this. In common, you have an external server, you call it the monitor. Still benefit. Then we also are playing with a development plan for a possible alternative for which is MySQL Replication and customized keep alive daemon. And the customization is where keep alive daemon would be able to fail over the MySQL instances as well, just to see if that would be a simpler setup than daemon. But it is something I wasn't mentioning because we're working on. But unfortunately not on Windows. There's just the market is really small. We have one client who wanted to run it on Windows and use it, it doesn't work, and they're willing to switch to Linux just to have a high availability. Of course you need Perl because the whole thing is written in Perl. It must have iThread enabled, which is I think on every installation by default. You need a whole bunch of modules. Has a exercises. It doesn't have too many production deployments. We're doing our first, as I said, in a few weeks. It's a bit tougher to install than 1.2.3 because it only has a tarball and debut packages. There are no RPMs, there is no repository, which is something that is all, you know, future plans, so to say. But it's not a big deal. Installing from tarball is easy. Security is not really necessary to remember, but it's something that I here, but that is really up to you. That includes the operating system part of your install. Then there is the MySQL part. You use the OurDelta MySQL. It has better performance. It will be better able to monitor what's going on with your server. It has more statistics. A bunch of stuff. Look on the website or see what it does. What it can provide answer for you. It has a convenient sense of web repository. So the instructions have been followed in your syntax are at ourdelta.org. Then there are some MySQL settings, minimum settings that you need on all the daemons. I say minimum because obviously you'll want loads more, but the tuning is not part of this talk, so you'll have to figure that out by yourself. But you'll at least need to enable the binary log and set a unique server ID for every data node in your cluster. This is actually only required for replication to function correctly. And for the two masters, you need to enable log save updates so that they will properly do the circular replication between them. Then you'll need a bunch of users. You can combine into one user if you want to, but I prefer three separate users. You need the user for the monitor. That's what the monitor connects to directly to see what the status of replication is. You'll need the agent user as the user the agent uses to connect to the MySQL instance on the same machine. And you'll need a replication user, obviously, that just does the replication, the MySQL replication. Then you set the replication. It's pretty easy. There's master one and both the slave one, slave two. And master 2 need to replicate from master 1, and master 1 needs to replicate from master 2. It's pretty straightforward to set up, but yeah. And once that is set up, you start the slaves and see if everything works properly, and make it that stable, whatever, see if it works, and if it gets properly through the replication. If it does, and you're starting from scratch, start bringing it into your master one and optimize to replicate through your whole cluster. That concludes the MySQL part of the install, and then all there is left is MMM. Unfortunately, as I said before, there is no RPM repository for CentOS, so you'll have to we use the tarball and manually separate the files and folders. It's a little bit back to work, but it's not the end of the world. All machines, you need a folder to log in, to put the logs in, you need a folder to put the config files in, and you need the bins like agent on the agent. On the monitor machine, and everything from the tarball goes into the corresponding folders on our sites. Then you'll need an MMM subdirectory in whatever protocol dynasty installed early those we use, and everything from the lib folder in the tarball was there. Then you have a copy of everything, and then you'll have to create a config file. This is a trimmed down version of configuration. One of the nice things is that you can include a config file in other config files. The way it's set up by default is that you'll create one config file that's at backend. And the last three states is hard offline. This is when machine disappears, network connection breaks, host goes out, whatever. Everything is severely wrong because it's hard offline. And then offline is when you instruct MMMs to put the hook. Features that I haven't seen in that, but everybody has their own preference for very nice thing is that in MySQL multiple, there was a talk about maybe it's tomorrow, I don't remember, in old SQL, about MySQL tools. Very nice to take a look at MySQL.org if you're using MySQL a lot. Maybe a table checksums all your tables on every node and it tells you which ones are different. Because even in normal replication setup, you will have data drift after a while because the way replication works, it's not always doing exactly what you think it is at all. Like you will have data drift because of replication delay or whatever. So running this in your front job every once in a while is a very simple way to make everything back to date. You can either have a group from a get to like some mail queue or whatever, or you can use empty table sync with the output from the checksum tool, and it'll automatically resync all the data for your whole cluster. Saves you a lot of time manually updating the data and figuring out where the discrepancies are, or maybe you'll find discrepancies that you haven't realized were there. Make sure your schema is suitable. It needs like a table sync, needs primary keys on every table. Sometimes it's very simple, but there are even open source tools that you can download that do not have primary keys on every table. So just do it. There are a bunch of ideas for improvement. I personally would like to see a real load balancer implemented. There's an idea from SQL proxy, but the problem with that is that it's inherently adds overhead to your next speed. Another option would be to customize HA proxy or some kind of real load balancing would be nice to complete the package of having a high availability failover solution with load balancing. Right now, the monitor is a single point of failure. It's not a big single point of failure because if it fails, the cluster will still keep running, but you lose your monitoring. Obviously, you would have a monitoring system monitoring the monitor. But you know, you want to know when your monitor goes down so you can see what's up. It doesn't disturb the production state, but you do want to solve it as soon as possible. And proper packaging would also be very nice. Pitfalls already covered them, no real load balancing. Some failover situations, will get confused if shit really hits the fan. Obviously, if you get confused, then you need manual intervention. But that's the way it is. I wanted to be a little bit more in detail about who's using imperfection, but this is all detail I give, so yeah, that's what it is. If you want to hear more different HA solutions, Len Grimmer is giving a talk at the Open SQL Camp in 15 minutes after I finish, and he'll be applying a couple of other solutions as well. So that was it. Anybody have any questions? The problem with setting up more than two masters is that you'll have, if one master goes down and you'll close the ring, you have a big probability of having replication events circling through your cluster. Because MySQL replication is set up in such a way that if you have circular replication, it'll stop when it reaches the master that it's already been to. So if you have more than three, you take out one, you connect the other two again, you have a circular replication. You could do that, but you want master. Oh, sorry. He's asking why not set up the masters in a way that every master produces data to all the slaves. master per se. So I can stop there. Not be able to see this. So you're left.